What's going on, everybody? Welcome back to the channel where I talk about watches, where I think that you can never own too many watches or talk too much about watches. And so a few days ago, I actually got a few requests about making a video where I tell you guys my opinion, what are some of the best watches for beginners in 2021. And I've actually set myself a mark up to $200 because I believe that if you truly want to get into watches and you know you're a little bit confused, don't know what to get, you still can save a little more money to get something nicer. So, I mean, if you guys truly want me to make a video, you know, of watches under $100 or under, you know, around $50 mark, I will try. Just let me know in the comments down below. But for today's episode, it will be watches up to $200. I wanted to go with mainly sports watches and just a couple of dress watches. I don't have any GMTs, any chronographs. I believe that those type of watches deserve a complete different video, so I will also make that in the future. But let's start with the dress watches, because I want to leave the sports watches for the end. I just like them better, and it's more fun with the dress, with the, you got it, sports watches. So the first watch I have right here is obviously the Orient Bambino. And be that the second, third, fourth, it's totally up to you, but the Bambino is actually a gorgeous watch. So it's actually a 40.5 millimeter case with only 11.8 millimeter thickness, 40 hour power reserve, not the best, not the worst. It also comes with a Japanese automatic movement with only, unfortunately, 30 meter water resistant, but also it's a dress watch, so I mean, you can't expect much from it. It has a date function, and also it depends on which one you get. There is a little bit of variety in them, you know, the Bambino 2 and then the 3 and the 4th, but they're very similar. So here really comes down to your personal preference. Yeah, the watch is stainless steel case and also comes on a leather strap. So perfect, perfect dress watch. Also, the price, it retails at about $120-140 American dollars. So the prices for all the watches will be in American dollars, so I don't confuse anybody. The next watch I have here is the Seiko SUP 880, and I actually own this one, and I had it for about a year now, and it's one of the most beautiful dress watches that you can find out there, especially at this price. Case dimension is 32 millimeters by 28.5. Again, this is a rectangular watch, so it works a little bit different. Guys, 6.1 millimeters thickness. This watch is thin and light, gorgeous. Now, the watch, again, it 30 meter water resistant dress watches, you can't expect much, but it's not automatic. It's actually solar powered. It's very comfortable on the wrist too. I mean, I really like it. Totally forgot, this watch retails at about $130. So again, very affordable. Next up, we have the sports watches. I love them. I absolutely love them. I will start actually with a Seiko. This is the Seiko SNZG. And then they come in, the 09 is a green, 11 is blue, and 15 is black. So, you know, they have a line of them, of the SNZG. The watches are 42 millimeter case, 12 millimeter thickness, 22 millimeter bandwidth, 100 meter water resistant, 40 hour power reserve, date at 3 o'clock position, which I really, really like that. It's a Japanese automatic movement, stainless steel case only, because it comes in with NATO strap. The watch retails at about $130 to $150. The next watch I have is the Seiko 5 SNK. This one comes at 38 millimeter case. I've actually had this watch. It's light, it's on the lighter side. I like the watches that are a little heavier, but that's just personal preference. But yeah, the watch is 38 millimeter case, 12 millimeter thickness, 19.5 bandwidth, with unfortunately only 30 meter water resistant. It's a sports watch. I would expect a little more from it, but the watch is only $95. It has 41 hour power reserve, stainless steel case and bracelet, and it has a day-date function at 3 o'clock located, which is great. For $95, you get not only the time, but the day and the date. Wonderful. Next up is one of the watches I own, and I've owned for about 4 years, and it's actually the first video that I did here on my channel, is the Invicta Pro Diver. This watch brings a lot of heat in any conversation that you bring it up. It's an homage watch for the Rolex Submariner. I don't really like homage watches. I'm sorry, I do own two. Invicta Pro Diver. It's 40 millimeter case, 13 millimeter thickness, 200 meter water resistant. Guys, I mean, I will also attach the link here so you guys can go watch my full review on it. Durable mineral glass, Japanese automatic movement, stainless steel case and bracelet. It's got a date function at 3 o'clock, and the watch is only about $80 to $95, $100 maximum, but you can find it cheaper. Now, the next three watches are actually all from the same brand, and they're all Orient. I have owned Orient in the past. I haven't owned any of these three, but I've gotten the chance to see them, feel them, and they're absolutely great. So the first one is the Orient Perpetual Calendar. This watch is gorgeous, is very unique. You don't really see watches designed that way. I mean, the dial is very interesting, but yeah. And the bracelet is something like you've never seen before. I really like how much it narrows from the lugs all the way to the clasp. Really nice. Great job, Orient. So this one is 43 millimeter case, a little bit bigger than my preference. I like 41, you know, ideal for me. 43 also is not bad. 12 millimeter thickness, which is really nice, very sleek. 50 meter water resistant, automatic movement, scratch resistant mineral crystal, stainless steel case and bracelet. And this watch retails for about $100. Great, great choice. The next Orient is called Mako 2. I believe that's how you pronounce it. This guy is beautiful. I really like it. I mean, if you show this watch to, I've showed the watch to many other people, and I've asked them, what do you think the value of the watch is? And everybody has valued it at way more than the watch actually is. Keep in mind, the watch costs only $125 to about $140. Absolutely gorgeous, 41.5 millimeter case with 13 millimeter thickness, 200 meters of water resistance. Incredible. Japanese automatic movement, mineral crystal, stainless steel case and bracelet. It has also date complication, guys. Screw down crown, obviously you need that, you know, if you want to have the 200 meter water resistant, you got to have the screw down crown. The watch is gorgeous. The last Orient I have, and is, I believe, a newer, or I should say the big brother of the Mako, it's the Orient Kamatsu. This one, it's 42 millimeter case, 13 millimeter thickness. The watch also is 200 meter water resistant, Japanese automatic movement, 40 hour power reserve, stainless steel case and bracelet. It's gotten the date function, position at 3 o'clock, just the way I like it. And the watch retails at $200. So I believe in my entire list of watches that I have here, $200 is the most expensive that I have. So it's this one. Somewhere you can actually find it for just a little bit more expensive than 200, but I mean, it's still a great watch. And the last, the god of all watches, is the G-Shock GA2100. It is the new release of the Casio G-Shock this year. Very different than any other G-Shocks you see out there. If, you know, I was never a fan of the G-Shock before because they're all big and bulky. I mean, they're indestructible. I will give them that. Style-wise, not my favorite, but this one, they really nailed it. It's just, it's gorgeous. It's 45 millimeter case, 11.8 millimeter thickness. So you don't get that bulkiness and big, ugly watch with 200 meter water resistance. I love that. And this watch retails for about $120. Guys, I hope you liked the video. This is what I believe that are some of the best watches for beginners that you can get in 2021. If you guys want me to do a different tier, like let's say up to $100 or something like that, I will also do. If you want me to do it up to $500, no problems. You guys just comment down below so I see that this is something you want. Please like the video, subscribe to the channel, and till next time.